Hi and welcome to this tutorial about the game Here I Stand. It will be about the Ottoman and what is special about them. Let's start with their home card called Janny Service. Can either give 5 CPs to use as you wish, or it has a choice between 2 very powerful abilities. The first one is to gain extra dice in a field battle or in naval combat. And what's especially powerful about this card is that you may see the dice of both sides before you decide if you're going to use it. So if you, for example, have just 2 hits and your opponent have 3 hits in a field battle, you might play this card to gain 5 extra dice and maybe score 2 extra hits to win the battle. The second ability is better. It's to add 4 new regulars, to build 4 new regulars to an Ottoman home space or a foreign war card. Essentially worth 8 CPs. What's also special about the Ottoman is that they don't only have regulars, they also can build cavalry. The cavalry costs just 1 CP as opposed to regular that costs 2 and adds other benefits. It makes it easier to intercept an opponent. You get plus 1 if to try to initiate combat in a neighboring area when they are passing, and you can also more easily avoid being intercepted by subtracting 1 from your opponent's interception die roll. So if the Ottoman is standing there and the Habsburg moves with his army here, the Ottoman may try to intercept, which usually requires a 9 or better with 2 dice. But if they have a cavalry present, they get plus 1, so they can intercept on an 8 or better. If they have a leader, they can also claim that bonus. And vice versa, if the Ottoman moves here and the Habsburg wants to intercept, the Habsburg has -1, so that they can only intercept on a 10. The disadvantage with cavalry is that they cannot provide dice when in a siege. They still count as a garrison. If the Habsburg are assaulting Belgrade and there is only 1 cavalry there, the Ottoman get 1 die because they are defender, but not 1 die for the cavalry. But the Habsburg is still halved when calculating their number of dice, as opposed as if Belgrade were empty. So let's move on to piracy. I've described piracy in another video, so if you want to know how the mechanics of it, you should watch that video. In this video we will just talk about how they appear and where they appear. And the Ottoman are not allowed to build pirates before this card is played, Barbary Pirates. It's in the deck from the start and it will be played at the end of turn 3 if not played before. This card turns the Algiers space here into an Ottoman key and adds 2 regulars and 2 corsairs and the Barbarossa evil leader to the area. Barbarossa is good in naval combat, a strategic rating of 2, and this P1 means that he adds 1 die when doing piracy. The Ottoman can get more pirate havens by the play of the card Pirate Haven, which is also in the deck from the start. This card turns one of either Tripoli or Oran into a pirate haven. They have to be a border a sea zone adjacent to fortified space under Ottoman control, which could be Algiers, for example, or North African coast, if they take Rhodes, for example. It adds one Ottoman regular and two corsairs, and this pirate haven marker. The spaces after that considered an Ottoman home space, and this is a fortress. It's fortified. You can only play this again if Tripoli or Oran belongs to another major power at war with the Ottoman. Also, the Algiers space is out of the game before the card Barbary Pirates is played. Eventually, later in the game, Barbarossa could die by the play of the mandatory card Dragut. Then Barbarossa is removed and replaced by the naval leader Dragut. This card enters on turn 6 and is never forced to play, so it doesn't have to happen during the game. Dragut is not as good in naval combat, just the one, but is better in piracy. That's a value of 2. The final thing, that card that has to do with the pirates, is the card Julio Gonzaga. And it's simply a way for the Ottoman to gain an extra victory points. If this is played and then later they score in the same turn, they score a hit in the Tyrrhenian sea zone. Down here. The Ottoman risk involving themselves in 2 foreign wars. There could be war in Persia, where the Persians have 4 land units and the Ottomans have to send 5 land units. And there could be revolt in Egypt, which is a little weaker. They have to send at least three land units, and the Egyptians have 3 land units. There is some potential for cooperation with France through the cards. La Forêt's embassy gives 1 card to them each if they are allied. And then Swiss mercenaries is just that when the Ottoman plays it, the French get 4 French mercenaries. And last, there are some special cards for the Ottomans, or that concerns the Ottoman. This card, Roxelana, which could send back Suleiman back to Istanbul or give him a free assault. Akinji Raiders, which could steal a card from an opponent through the cavalry. Knights of St. John, which if they are on the board and they start in Rhodes, ordering to an Ottoman controlled port, they steal 1 card from the Ottoman and builds on St. Peter's construction in Rome for the papacy. Janissaries rebels. It's just that they get unrest in some part of the Ottoman Empire. Then finally, John Sapoloya. It's not really with the Ottoman to do, but it adds 4 regulars to the power, to the area named Buddha, and this basically makes it forces the Ottoman to be quicker when they conquer Hungary. Otherwise the army of Hungary will grow and it will become harder. The Ottoman starts the game at war with Hungary, and usually they try to beat Hungary quite fast. Hungary are these light green areas. There are 2 ways for the Ottoman to beat Hungary. Either if Hungary Bohemia has been activated as an Habsburg ally through diplomatic marriage, Then they are beaten when the Ottoman controls two keys of Hungary, Bohemia, which will usually be Belgrade and Buda. The other more common way to beat them is that they control one home key, and there are four or fewer regulars from Hungary, Bohemia remaining on the map. And that's usually Belgrade and the Buda. In Buda, it starts five Hungarian units. So if they beat them in a field battle, there will be fewer than four regulars, and the Hungary surrenders. What happens then is that the Habsburg intervenes at no cost, get the Hungarians as allies for the rest of the game. It can never be deactivated. All Hungarian home spaces where there is an Ottoman land unit become under Ottoman control. All the Hungarian units under siege are eliminated. So if they beat the Hungarians in Buda and there are a few left, they are removed and Buda becomes Ottoman. The Ottoman also gets two victory points as a war winner. This situation represents the end of the Ottoman-Hungarian War. The Ottoman and the Habsburg are still having peace, and the Ottoman has taken Belgrade. They have one cavalry unit in Mohács. They have conquered Szegedin and have six regulars and one cavalry and the two leaders, and they have just paid one CP to move to Buda. The Hungarians have five troops in Buda and one in Prague, and there are some Habsburg troops in Vienna. So they moved to Buda since Hungarians are more than four. They have to fight a field battle, calculating how many dice. The Ottoman gets 7, 8, 9 for the leader. So we'll roll 9 die. No hit. One hit. The Hungarians get to roll 6 die. Oh, 3 hits. 4 hits. So the Hungarian lose one troop, and the Ottoman loses four troops, and thus loses the field battle and has to move back to Szegedin. Since the Hungarians have five or more troops on the board, they won't surrender, since the requirement for that is that they have lost one key, Belgrade, and are four or less regulars left on the tape on the board. Say that the Ottoman wouldn't have lost any troops, so that they had killed one of the Hungarians and the Hungarians zero, and thus the Hungarians had lost. Then they would still not don't surrender, since they have five troops, and now they can move into Buda, and a siege would take place with an assault next turn. The third option is that the Ottoman actually wins the battle. Say that the Ottoman lose zero troops and the Hungarians lose three troops, so that they have only two left. Then they in total have four or less, so they will surrender. And this means all Hungarian troops that are under siege are removed, like this one. And the Ottoman takes control of that. Ottoman is also awarded two victory points. And also every Hungarian region where there is an Ottoman troop falls under Ottoman control. like Mohawks. At the same time, Hungarians ally with Habsburg for the rest of the game. So the rest of Hungary falls under Habsburg control. The intervention costs 0 CP for the Habsburg player. And the declaration of war doesn't cost anything either. That concludes the tutorial about the Ottoman.